Hello, dear tea friends from around the world, and welcome to my little live Instagram video. I am about to make some tea, and I thought let's share some thoughts. Let's show you how I'm making my tea. The tea I'm making is my 2003 Yiwu Yesheng Pu'er. It's beautiful leaves. It has really aged very well since 2003, and the reason this tea is really, really very important and significant for me, it's because it's one of the very first teas that I've started to collect after starting to take tea lessons with T. Parker almost 18 years ago. Okay, so I'm preheating the gray one first. In the background, maybe you can hear some music. It's music from Oded Tsur, Here Be Dragons. Oded is a very good tea friend of mine, and he's composing his own music. He's playing saxophone, and all his music actually is inspired by tea. And this album, his third now, is maybe the one that is the most slow, meditative, and yeah, really the one I love to listen to when I'm making tea. It's really so relaxing. It helps to get in the mood for a very slow and meditative tea. My guy one is ready. Fired up. To be silent while emptying the water in the cups to learn to pay attention to how I'm making the tea. I've just preheated the water, so it's still very hot and boiling. See, I did not put much inside. Now we have a little bit time since it's a tea that takes some time. I did not use too many leaves. You saw it's very precious because it's now quite old. Hello Ula. Now today I'm a bit closer to my telephone, so I can see who is on. So don't hesitate to ask questions if you have any. And I'm very glad to do this in front of you. And so my I'm a bit reflecting nowadays because I've also reached now almost 18 years of learning tea with T. Parker. And when you practice something for a long time, you get better at it. As I remember my management professor telling me in business school, like 25 years ago, said, once you are very good at something, you have to stop doing it and try something new. You cannot, even if you are very, very good at it, you will start to feel bored. You will start to have some patterns that recurring patterns that start to fossilize you, that put you always in the same situation. You start to look more for comfort than to take risks, and then you risk not improving anymore. So, hello. Thank you. So the idea is that you always have to push the limits. You always have to do something a little bit different. And this is a bit, yeah, something I'm thinking with the practice of tea, like with the practice of good music. Of course, a musician, you cannot tell him, oh, stop playing your instrument, because he's getting better and better at it. But maybe he wants to try to find higher notes, different notes. So not always playing the same songs, but or if you play the same songs, playing them a little bit differently. So with tea, if you are practicing tea for a long, long time, you always have to do some things to change. Now, one of the things that I'm always trying to do, first, as you can see, is my chashi. I never, almost very rarely, do twice the same chashi. So not only because the chabu are different, but also how I combine the cups with the gaiwan, with all my elements. I always try to find a total harmony in all of this teaware with the tea, and I will try to make it that it's always a bit different. The idea, again, when you do something for a long time, if you just repeat always the same thing, it becomes dead. So to keep the passion alive also, you always have to take risks, try something new, try to be creative. I think this, always changing the chashi, thinking of a different plan. So for instance, let's take this example today. Here the fabric in the middle is a composite of different patterns. And for me, this really expresses jazz music very well. And it's a bit, the arrangement is seems a bit random, but in total you achieve harmony. And the green on the side, of course, is for life. So the inside is dark, like a jazz music played at night seems a bit dark. But the green is life. So a little bit like this tea. Why do I think of this tea now with this chashi? Is because aged almost 20 years old, poor, now from the outside, the leaves, they look quite dark. It's called recha, black tea in Chinese, poor. But when you drink it, actually, it's still full of life because it's a shengpu. Okay. Let me show you a bit the color, a very beautiful orange color. So, yeah, and it's sweet, but it has pungency. And it's very clean, very, very clean, very clean, very sweet. Mellow, and it tickles a bit the taste buds. Now, this is just how little I've used. So, because it's already 20 past 5 in the afternoon in Taipei, so if you drink your pour too strong in the afternoon, there's a risk for not sleeping at night. So I like to drink any tea at any time of the day, but what I'm a bit careful at is looking at the quantity of leaves that I'm using. So especially for gushu pour, for wild pour, I'm using always very few leaves, especially so late in the day. Mm. Also it's lots of nice woody notes, dark wood, and yeah, feels like in an old temple. Yeah, excellent transparency. So that's also a very nice thing with the pour, as I was talking about change. It's a tea that I've been able to monitor from the very early on, from the very first year until now, seeing how it's changing. So even though I'm drinking every year the same tea, it's never exactly the same tea, because it continues to age, it continues to transform also. And the same way that the tea becomes now smoother and sweeter, the same way as it improves, I also hope that my practice helps me to improve. So it's here all about finding this balance between change, experimentation, but also practice and learning, continuing. Hello, thank you for joining my little live video. I've just performed my first brew of this 2003 Wild Ewu Pour, my kick. Unfortunately, it's almost sold out on my website. I have very little left, so I'm more trying to make it available in small quantities so that many people can still try it, taste it, rather than selling one big kick at a time. And well, actually, maybe in the future there'll be again some more larger quantity available. It depends on my son, because I've purchased a tong of this pour when he was a baby, and the idea is that when he's 18, this tong will become his, and he can do what he wants with it. If he wants to make some money for, I don't know what his dreams will be, then he could maybe have the tea sold on my website. But I still encourage him to learn and enjoy it. The first brew still lingers on my tongue and on my palate. Very sweet, really no roughness at all. Very, very, very pleasant. Despite using a porcelain gaiwan and not an Yixing teapot that rounds the edges. For the second brew, I'm a bit faster. Like liquid gold, such a beautiful transparent color. And the last drop has to come out, but we do this slowly, in no hurry. The whole process is about to make us calm, serene, enjoying the moment. Yeah, this gift definitely turned out well. So it shows that the learning was not in vain, and that T. Parker did really have a very good foresight to recommend that I purchase this tea. Beautiful. Nice. Well, so I'm still trying to find ways to push to make this a creative step as well as a regular practice. Now, so there are good habits and bad habits, huh? If you always have a habit of doing the same thing, it could be bad because it does not make you creative. You do things too automatically, and then you don't challenge your brain enough to create something new. But there are also good habits, especially drinking tea. I think is a very good habit because it has so many positive side effects, benefits. You learn to calm down, to disconnect from the 3C. Well, now we are on Instagram, but usually when you drink tea, you put your phone on the side, maybe except when you take some pictures. But it's a way to reconnect to yourself and to enjoy very simple. A simple happiness, and find to be able to find happiness in something simple is very very valuable nowadays. So, and especially if this habit makes you very happy, then definitely you should not consider it as something bad. So for me, I like to make my tea habit also always a little challenging by making a different chashi for the occasion. Now the reason I'm using this tea I just explained, huh, because of the significance of the change over time, of the significance that it's dark. And the reason I'm using this teaware is because as I was saying, I'm trying to analyze to understand this tea better, how it's evolving, and using porcelain without the smoothing effect of Yixing, you're really getting to the real taste of the tea. And if now I can feel that it's really very smooth and mellow, it's really only because of the tea and not because of the teapot that I'm using. By brewing it a bit lighter, it's also easier to drink now that I get a bit thirsty from talking so much. Yeah, thank you for your comments. Ula, every tea is new sensations, new thoughts, new being in the now. Exactly. And these singing cups also are very light and very thin, very large, so they in summer they cool down the tea faster, so it's easier to drink now. And being porcelain also, white porcelain, you can see the transparency, the color very well, and it does not change the taste. And I'm using ivory porcelain instead of Celadon white, because this ivory white enhances a little bit this yellowish hue of the aged pour brew. When it becomes older, now the pour changes from greenish to orange, and then these cups are more suitable than Celladon cups. Okay, let's do a third brew. Oh, we have a strong afternoon sun now for the sunset in a few minutes. I hope you can see well. While the water is boiling, I show you again these beautiful leaves. Really very good pour leaves. They will be a bit shiny when you look at them like this in the sun. The buds are the leaves that are the lightest in color. Here they are golden orange, but in the larger leaves have already become very, very dark. Now for the third brew, I'm going to use a little bit more strength in order to extract more aromas from the leaves. So put a little bit more water than last time, so it will take a little bit longer now to brew, and I will need a little bit to be very careful not to burn my fingers when the water is so high. Actually in Taiwan, there are some very good mineral waters, like Yess, but it's not so convenient to carry always mineral water. So I'm using actually water from the tap, but with two filters, and one pre-filter and one more stronger filter from Everpure, and this makes a good quality water. With the water coming from the rain collected in the mountains and then in the reservoirs in around Taipei, and so the water quality in Taiwan actually is already quite good, so I don't really need to Chinese it much more, since it's a water that has already come into contact with nature in Taiwan.
Where do you get your water?
So that's why I'm not using bamboo charcoal myself, because it's already tasting good enough. But actually I found out that inside my filter they use charcoal to filter out some bad things, it's a similar charcoal in my filter, so maybe this also adds a good taste to the tea, to the water first and then the tea. Okay. Okay, so I was also talking about change and always improving. So in recent years, I've tried to be a bit more creative, one with photography. I hope you can see that my pictures have a bit improved over the years on the blog and also on Instagram. I've also tried to provide more interesting materials through PDFs that I give to people who purchase my teas and wares. And so I've written a Oolong Brewing Guide. I've written two guides about museums, the British Museum, the Chinese Porcelain Collection, and the National Palace Museum in Taipei and in close to Alishan, I forgot the name, and with their teaware collection. So that guide actually is one museum but with two branches, the northern and the southern branch. And so within there you can really see in these two museum guides some top ancient wares that were used by Chinese emperors, and it's very interesting to see that actually we're lucky to be able to use beautiful cups and bowls, little plates that some that come from the Qing dynasty, but and or some modern wares that are very delicate, just as delicate as those wares that the emperors were using. Oh, this one has more aftertaste because I've pushed it a bit stronger and also longer. Very good. And the fourth PDF, the fourth ebook I wrote was last year, a novel, a short story about an emperor and his sons and daughters and a dream he had about tea. I hope that I've heard good feedback and many people liked it a lot. And now my latest project I'm just starting, and maybe I wanted to have some feedback from you, is to write again a more educational ebook about learning how to become a tea master. So I was thinking of different practical exercises of what somebody can do to become a tea master. And so first I was wondering if this is something that is interesting to you, and if you have any comments on things that you would like to learn, because over the years I've written a lot in my blog, and as I said, you don't want to repeat yourself, always doing the same, so I don't want to repeat myself, I want to do it a little bit different. No, thank you very much, Ulla, for this compliment about my pictures. So, well, even if you don't have any feedback, it's okay. Just to let you know that if I'm not, if I'm a little bit less present on my blog, it's also part of this process of not repeating myself and always doing the same, but also because I'm working on this new project of writing again a very educational ebook about learning to become a tea master. And but it's not aimed at professionals, it's aimed at any person who loves tea and who wants to go farther and have more understanding of how to taste, how to brew, and how to appreciate tea. So one thing, but I think a boon would potentially reach wider audience. What is a boom or a zoom? what is a boom? Don't worry about repeating. Well, I know the a teacher should not be worried about repeating himself. Just I'm a lazy teacher, and who does not like to be, who does not like to do the same things over and over again, in terms of teaching. Oh, a book. Yeah. So, well, so far these are e-books that I'm writing, that I've written. So there are already four that I've written, and I'm thinking more of this new one would be a bit more really very practical, in with exercises, like one page, one exercise. I don't want to. Many people have written very comprehensive books about tea. And maybe I'm not yet ready to do something like that, but oh, hello, Shumin, drinking some good tea. But yeah, so I was thinking of something that's a bit different, like really practical exercises to learn how to become a tea master. The inspiration actually came from an ebook I purchased to learn photography. So to learn photography, they were saying, okay, now today, learn about color, take pictures like this, the next day, or composition, take pictures like that. Third exercise, learn about, the lighting, and see how you can make different exercises about lighting. So the spirit would be to do something in that direction, and so I think this has not been done very much. Now I don't tell too many people, it's not yet out, just on the beginning. Okay, many people have joined, so let me, I don't know if you can hear the sound in the background, it's from my friend Odette Sour, his latest album, Here Be Dragons, on the label ECM, but you can also get it on my website, teamasters.com. Oh, it's the first time I mention it, I'm really not very good at self-promotion, and so it was published in this year, just out of the press. It's Odette's third album, and I think the most meditative one, the slow one, and a really very good music to relax and to drink tea at the same time. And not only is it music to make tea, but I think the reason it is, it's because Odette is a tea friend who enjoys drinking tea, so the tea has brewed and inspired him, and we are now able to enjoy his music also thanks to the inspiration that he got from tea. Ah. Now, this is now his last song on the album, Can't Help Falling in Love. This is the only one that he has done a cover. All the other songs are his own creations. But this means it's also time for me to wrap it up. I hope that you've enjoyed watching me drink tea. I hope you had some tea on the side yourself. And thanks very much for following me and supporting my adventures. Yeah, there was an anniversary I did not really mark this year. It's a strange year, 2020. In end of July, early August, it's the time that I started to be professionally involved in tea now 16 years ago. So yeah, to my long life, to my little tea business. and I hope to continue to find good teas and create good content to share with you my passion for tea. This was excellent. Thank you for sharing. Oh, thank you very much. I appreciate having your teaware PDF with me when visiting the British Museum last summer. Oh, thank you. I'm glad you found it useful. It's, because I try to add some information that you don't see in the museum for my two PDFs about National Palace Museum tea collection and the British Museum collection. I've tried to create some my own content. It's not just me taking my pictures at the museum and putting the copying what they write, but I try to put my own words, my own thoughts about the teawares that I present, how important they are to tea lovers from around the world, and I'm glad that you could see them at the British Museum, and when the crisis will be over, I hope many will come to Taiwan and visit the National Palace Museum and the teaware over there. Okay, thank you very much for watching. See you next time.